So, getting straight to the video, this is about my first tattoo experience. As you can see, it is right here. I will get into the details of everything a little bit moving forward. So I've been wanting a tattoo since I was little. I used to like draw words right here, or right here, like on the other side, over here, write words here. Just like anything that I would want to put on my body. I always wanted a sleeve. We're gonna talk about that later too. But so most of my life, obviously, your parents are gonna be like, you can't get a tattoo. No, illegal. But I'm 20 now, so what finally prompted me to get this tattoo was my mom just got hers. Once your parents like do something that they told you that you couldn't do for whatever reason, you can't say nothing to me now, because then you're gonna be a hypocrite. So guess who's getting a tattoo? I spoke to her about it. She was like, yeah, fine, whatever, I got mine, fine. I'm like, that's the spirit. That's the spirit. Great. I knew that I wanted something on my arm because, again, I always wanted a sleeve. I don't know if I'm gonna like continue to do it. Most likely I will, just because that's what I want. So I was looking up different tattoo places in the area. My mom went to Virginia for hers. She was on vacation. I was looking up like local ones, because I'm not going to Virginia. Like, who has time for that? Who's getting on a plane, first of all? So you do that to prevent getting lipstick on your teeth, but now it's on your hand, so
you stupid.
You played yourself. So yeah, I was looking up different places in the area where I could possibly like go get the tattoo from, and I came across one. It's called Rebel Ink Tattoo. Or is it just Rebel Ink? I think it's Rebel Ink Tattoo. Anyway, it's on Crosby Boulevard in Queens. I will like insert their Instagram and everything like that. So I looked at the reviews. Everybody said, oh, it's very clean, the artists are very nice, they all have like their unique styles, and overall very clean. That's what I was looking for. So I looked on their Instagram page, found their number, and they were like, oh, we have like open spots available for this week. If you want to do walk-ins too, you can. So I was like, okay, all right, cool. So I saw the number, I called, and the artist that did mine, his name was Giovanni. So he answered the phone. He was just like, oh, so like, what would you like to get done? I told him that I'm still juggling a couple ideas, it's my first tattoo. He wasn't like very like, okay, so like, send it over. Like, cause you know, like some tattoo artists are like very like fast paced. He wasn't like that. He was like, you know, you can come in on Saturday. I think it was a Saturday. You can come in on Saturday. Just send me the design by Thursday, Friday, so I can like draw it up for you. So I was like, all right, cool, thank you. Schedule my appointment. So the Friday came, I believe it was a Friday. My dates are all over the place. It's December, cut me some slack. So I was like looking on Instagram the whole, it was a while, but like I finally decided that I wanted the idea of a butterfly tattoo for my first one. So I came across this picture, and it had like half wing and half like flowers, and I was just like, that's me. I showed it to my mom. She was like, that is so you. I'm like, right? Right? I showed her coworker. Her coworker was like, yo, why does this look like something that you would get? So I'm like, you tell me, but I know, right? Well, I finally like decided like this is what I'm gonna get. I had screenshotted it and sent it to Giovanni. I will also put his information down below so you guys can go check him out, because he's really good. So the whole week my mom was like, oh, you know, because I was asking her like, did it hurt? I mean, obviously it hurt. It's a needle. I'm like, did it hurt? Did you pass out? Blah, blah, blah. She was like, no, I didn't really feel anything, but everybody's different. I don't really know my pain threshold. So I was just like, whatever happens, it happens, like, whatever. So the Saturday comes, my appointment was for 3. I was stressing because it was like 2:20 and we were just leaving the house. And I'm like, be late and then they're gonna have to reschedule me, and I'm not in the mood because I just want to get it done today. And it was pouring rain, but we got there and they were again very nice. They were like, oh, just put your name, fill this sheet out, and yeah, just email us the tattoo again, the sketch again, and we'll draw it up for you. So I sent it to them. And there was this one girl, she had me dying. She was like with her friend and her boyfriend, and she's like, Bibi, what do you think I should get? So then she goes, I'm gonna put promise on my pinky. Right, Bibi? And her best friend is just like, can you just make the decision so we can go? Like, I don't got all day. And he's just like, yeah, babe, whatever you want. So she gets her tattoo done in like 5 minutes because it's on her pinky, like you're getting problems with her. Okay, so yeah, then I go in and I meet Giovanni, and he sits me down. There's this big buff guy and he's like, is this your first tattoo? And I'm like, yes. And he's like, yeah, how's your pain threshold? And I'm like, I don't know, sir. He has like tons of them. So I'm like, okay, like, what am I in for? So my mom is sitting in front of me, right? Like this, cheesing at me. You gonna cry? You think you're gonna cry? I'm like, mom, please, can you please stop looking at me? I'm gonna cry if you keep looking at me like that. So he puts the stencil that he drew out on my arm. He was like, you know, if you put it like, all right, so you guys see it. Basically, it was like straight originally, but he said if you put it like slanted, it would look like it's going up somewhere. So if I ever like wanted to add on to it, it would look more real, you know. So I was like, all right, checked it out. I was like, all right, I'm ready. Let's get it. Okay, let's get it. So he starts. The noise. If you're planning to get a tattoo, prepare yourself for the noise, because that noise initially you're like, all right, okay. I'm a thug, I can do this. He starts, and honestly, it didn't hurt that bad. I didn't flinch. I was just like, oh. Oh. Okay, my mom's just like the smile like slowly faded away, because she's like, why aren't you crying? Why aren't you flinching? Like, only when it came to the shading. So that's another thing. The shading is going to like hurt a little bit more because it's shading. It's just gonna hurt more. So just keep in mind, like, if you're trying to get a tattoo with like shading involved, then be in mind that like the outlines and stuff won't hurt as much as shading, and you're gonna hear it much louder. So when he was finally done, it took like maybe 15 minutes, if that. Was it like 15 minutes? Maybe like 15 minutes once he started. And yeah, when he was done, I was like, that's it? He's like, yeah, that's it. I'm like, oh, wow. And like I turned and he showed it to me in the mirror and I was like, whoa, that's on me. Basically, he put something over my arm and was like, you know, take it off over an hour. After an hour, just like lightly wash it with some water, like just pour some water over it, wash it, whatever, and then let it air dry. And then you want to put just a little bit of Aquaphor over the next 5 days, and then 5 days after that, you put like Lubriderm on it to keep it moisturized. You only want to put a thin layer, because you don't want it to like start peeling or anything too early, like mess up the design, because it is still drying on your skin. I was just like, wow, okay. So, price. I will say everybody's different. Everybody's tattoo shop is different, so the prices will vary. This itself was $250. So, yeah. I thought it was pretty good because it is very detailed. Hold on. It is very detailed. Like, it looks, if I put up the picture, it'll probably like look just exactly like it. Overall it wasn't bad. I would just say beforehand, just look up who you want, look up the different shops in the area, check the reviews, make sure that it is a good place, make sure it's certified and everything like that. You don't want to just go anywhere because you can get infected. So, yeah. Overall, it was a good experience. Do I want more? Yes, I do. I've always wanted tattoos, so I'm most likely going to get more tattoos. Would I recommend anyone to get them? I mean, like, if you want, you can, because it's your body. You can do whatever you want with it. Oh, the meaning. Everybody was like, what does that mean? It's just a butterfly. And I'm like, basically, for me, this just signifies that I'm never completely what anybody expects me to be. You know, people take one glance at you, they assume that, like, you're either, like, oh, you think you're stuck up, or they think that you think that you're perfect, or whatever this is. But for me, it's just, like, I know that I'm different, and I'm okay with that. I'm very comfortable with me, with my, very secure with my uniqueness, you know, so that's what that means for me. Because nobody ever sees, like, oh, you know, a butterfly and flowers. It's like, whoa, there, whoa, I thought it was gonna be, whoa. But yeah, so. Yeah, so, like, at the end of the day, I'm very glad that I got it. I want more. More is coming soon. The recovery went very smoothly. You know, it just, you don't want to scratch it. You don't want to irritate it. You just want to, like, just pour, like, water over it every day. I just use water. Some days I would use oil, because oil heals it too. So I put, like, almond oil or castor oil on it. But yeah, I would definitely do it again. So, yeah, that was my first tattoo experience, and I'm looking forward to filming more and getting more. Maybe one day I'll have a sleeve and I'll do a whole thing on that. Who knows? Anyway, so, yeah, thanks for watching. Thank you guys for suggesting this. Yeah, you should subscribe. You should. If you want, but you should. You should. You should just should. Like, comment, any more ideas for any videos, let me know, hit me up. Tune in next time. My name's Liz, and you're watching Disney Channel.